Hey everyone, I'm Samyak Agarkar and welcome to Agarkar Media Academy. This is the 17th tutorial in Blender animation series for beginners. In the last tutorial, we looked at array modifiers and curve modifiers to create really great, amazing structures inside of Blender. Now, in this tutorial, we are going to look at a few more modifiers. Let's just start with the cube. We have here the default cube. In the modifiers panel here, we go to the next modifier, which is really important, which is the bevel modifier. Now, in the edit mode tools also, in the last few tutorials, you can see we learned what beveling is. Beveling is basically smoothing out of the edges. Now, that was in edit mode. There we had to select ourselves the edges and we had to smoothen the edges by ourselves by selecting the edges. Now, here in the bevel modifier, the edges are selected by default. They are selected themselves and we just don't need to do it again and again. Now, here let's look at the properties there. Now, here we have the offset. So, offset is basically how much width of the beveling you want. Here we have few different options. You can just look at them. Here are other things you may or may not want to use them. That's just when we have, you know, really complicated objects, then you can just turn on and turn off these properties to look at what is happening really. Now, segments, let's look at the segments. We saw in the bevel tool also there in the edit mode that beveling the segments is basically how many vertices or how many divisions will be there at the edge to smoothen it out. The more the divisions, the smoother it will look, but the more vertices and faces will be created, which will, you know, affect the rendering process. So mostly 3 or 4 gets the job done, and if you want more smoothing, you can just always increase the segments. Profile is basically the profile of the object, how closer and how farther away it will look. So 0 is the beveling inside, 1 is beveling outside, and 0.5 is beveling in the middle, right? Material is basically you can assign a material there, but we are not going to look at that just right now. Here we have the meter types. You can just select some things from here. So these are not really visible just right now because we have a very simple object right here. When we use complex objects, then these options will be useful. Right now it is not. Let's just look at one more thing which is being added in the bevel modifier in the latest versions, that is the 2.82, I think. In the 2.82, the custom profile was added. So when we turn on the custom profile here, you can see I can have as many segments as I want. Let's say I have 25 segments here. Still it is looking straight. Why? Because the profile of the segment is straight. Here what we can do is we can smoothen it out. We can have different shapes to the bevel the way we want. So this is really, really cool. This is really awesome. We can have custom shapes to the bevels, and that is really beneficial when we are using the bevel modifier. So we can have custom shapes. We can create, here are some presets which you can use, support loops. So that's about loops. We can select one more. So these are all the different custom profiles which we can use on the bevel modifier here. So that is really awesome. So you can create your own bevel profile also just by dragging the handles here. So the number of handles are decided by the number of segments. If we have less segments, let's say we have 4 segments, and then we go for the steps, then the steps will be less. And here you can, of course, drag the handles to create custom profiles. So that is all about bevel modifier. Bevel modifier is basically smoothing out of the bevels, but by custom profiles inside of bevel, we can have custom shapes to the bevels without doing the shapes ourselves. So that is very useful. Let's just look at one more modifier in this panel. Let's look at the mirror modifier. So mirror, as the object of, as the modifier name already suggests, it mirrors the objects. So if I just click on mirror objects, if I go to the edit mode, and if I just move, here you can see two objects have been created. So whatever I do here will be duplicated there also. So that is the use of mirror modifier. If I edit here, this part will be edited by itself. So I don't need to do it twice. So if you want a symmetrical object creation, then this type of mirror modifier is really, really useful. Now, this is also, let's just select all of it and let's just move it aside. We have the axis here. We can use the x-axis, we can use the y-axis, and we can use the z-axis. If we turn on all of it, of course, we will be having all of them by default. So here we have some really amazing or not so amazing things going on just right here. So it is being duplicated or mirrored in the x-axis also and in the y-axis also. That is the use of a mirror modifier. Of course, there are some merge limits and stuff like that. We'll be looking at them when we use the mirror modifiers in some real life applications. This tutorial is just about how what modifiers are available and what you can do with the modifiers. So these are the two modifiers that we learned in this tutorial. One was the bevel modifier and one was the mirror modifier. So in the next tutorial, we are going to look at a few more modifiers which are really, really useful to create awesome shapes inside of Blender. So that is it for this video. If you haven't yet subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. If you have any queries or comments, please comment down in the comment section below. Please share this video with your friends and families who might be interested in learning Blender. Blender is a free software for 3D animation, and that is really, really great. So see you in the next tutorial. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning.